to meet him. I don't know him as long as you've known him, but we've known each other for a long, long time. And I said, hey, take the weekend and come ride on the bus with us for Signature Sound. And he said, you know, some have make a wish to go to Disney World. Mine is to be in a quartet. And that weekend was special. And I called Scott and I said, hey, who do you have playing piano for the Old Friends set in Nashville? And he says, nobody yet. I said, I got the man. And so, buddy, thank you.
He mentioned my being sick, and I've gotten on a lot of things. I know about pain because I had a tumor for 6 months I didn't know about. It was the size of two softballs and hard as a brick. I know about endurance, being on chemo at St. Jude off and on for the last 4 years. I know about the swing from when you hear congratulations, you're in remission, to a few months later hearing it's back and you're going to be on chemo indefinitely. I know all about that. But I also have learned a little bit about the goodness of God. Romans chapter 5 tells us that we glory in our tribulations also. That doesn't make any sense. But when I first got sick, Roger's widow, Debbie Bennett, gave me a message and said, God will never give you more than you can be trusted with. And that makes so much more sense. When Jesus says in this world, you're going to have tribulations. You're going to have problems. You're going to have health issues. Your kids are going to do something stupid. You're going to do something stupid. Tax day is coming. They're going to hate you because they hated me. But be happy about it. I've already overcome the world. So Romans says we glory in our tribulations also. Why? Because tribulation works patience. And let me tell you something, when you're in the valley of the shadow of death, it will try your patience. Many of you know that. And patience works experience. Experience in what? Experience it in those darkest days when you try to pray and the heavens seem to be made of brass and just bounce right back in your face. Those are the very moments that God is working the hardest to fulfill Romans 8:28 and work all things out for good to them that love the Lord and them who are called according to his purpose. And this is my favorite. Experience works hope. What hope? The hope that my Jesus is everything he claimed to be. If he's one comma less than he claimed to be, we're wasting our time tonight. We're all lost. But he's so much more. Listen. It's very possible. I'm still fighting this stuff. I go back to St. Jude on Wednesday, actually. It's very possible the cancer is going to kill this body. But you know what? Tomorrow makes the 11-year anniversary of my healing. When I gave Jesus Christ my everything. Made him Lord my that I can say, I'm gonna live forever. You know, I love him. So, you know, Bill Gaither in the early 70s wrote it in a song that says it far better than I ever could. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.